My name is Rafael Basaldúa. I train at Jace Johnson Karate Center and Niall Peña Boxing Club.
I'm Jonathan the Dream Thompson. I'm from Minneapolis, Iowa. I train with Militage Fighting Systems in Bettendorf, Iowa. I get my butt kicked every day. It's refreshing. The guys are just as good or way better than me, and it's something I needed. It's something I needed to make my move to a better level, a higher level, make me better.
He's a pretty cool kid, very tough. He knows a lot. I respect him. But now it's about business. It's about he's got something that I really want to have. And I tell you, I'm gonna do everything in my power to get that belt.
I tell everybody what I do. There's no hiding what I do. You're gonna know that you're gonna get punched in the face. You're gonna get kicked in the face. You're gonna get kneed. I'm gonna do everything and everything I can. I have a team. I'm training. He has a team. He's training.
I guarantee you, I'm gonna use my hands a lot more this time. That's something, something that you're gonna see for sure. That's gonna be the difference, you know?
I'm faster, I'm quicker. I like to be the small 170, not the big 155. I'm pretty good about getting up to my feet, and that's where I wanna be. It's on my feet, standing, striking, you know? I'm a wrestler. I love the wrestler. I can hold you down and I can beat you up.
Well, obviously, you never know what's gonna happen in a fight. It's a fight, and everything can change. It takes 1 second. Either they're knocked out or get your opponent out.
Be ready, man. Train hard. I know you got a good team behind you. Right now, it's about, you know, getting better, but this is business, so bring you your best.
I mean, it's a competition. That's the way I see it. A new challenge for me. Like I said, I love the challenge. I love the competition, and we'll see what happens. But you guys are gonna have fun. I'm gonna have fun. Jonathan is gonna have fun. Everybody's gonna be happy. Showtime, baby.
Goes out to Rafael for taking the fight on short notice. It has to be extremely difficult to, you know, just say a week beforehand that, hey, I'll jump in the ring.
Right, and you know what? Nothing surprised me there, too. Like I said, I personally know Rafael for a long time now, and he's one of those guys that is there every day training, morning and night, helping out really one of the big names at Jay Johnson's. And they were formerly Evolution and kind of just, you know, merged into Jay Johnson's and really been there the whole time. And just a grizzled fighter goes in there, injured, whatever. One of those that makes no excuses and just really fights. So he's definitely going to be a good fight tonight.
To come in, you know, you're preparing, and you're ready to fight one person, and then at the last minute, you're switching, you got to fight somebody completely different.
It really just goes back to what you trained for, your tools. They're still the same, no matter what your opponent is. You just have to tweak up your game plan a little bit. But all your training is still good. It still counts, obviously, you know, but it really tests your heart and your mental state. And really, that's where it's at. I mean, you're still the same fighter, just different opponent.
Right. You know, I was fortunate to be able to go to MFS and see him actually working on his craft in person. And, you know, he was definitely working hard, was very, very, very enthusiastic about it, too. So those are all great signs, regardless of who your opponent is.
And both of these guys have definitely been in there before with their records, as the records show. And so we're really going to see a high level of MMA tonight. There's going to be really no feeling out. It's not their first debut fight, or even, you know, they're not 3-0 or 2-1 and anything like that. We're really going to see some good mixed martial arts tonight with this fight.
Trying to use the cage to get a little leverage and get up.
And with Bazadua's back to the cage, I mean, you can also wall walk too if you can just kind of inch your body slowly up the cage. But, you know, easier said than done, as we don't have a guy laying on top of us to do that, so.
Both guys sort of just battling for position.
Right now, Thompson looking to trap that left, that right arm of Bazadua with his knee. Rafael doing a good job of staying active and trying to inch his way around. Really use that cage and then flip over. And Rafael can look into his corner for some advice. Surprisingly, you can hear a lot of things in the corner from the fighter's point of view in the cage. out, but just neutralize him and really keeping him about to do it where he wants him. Nice up kick from Bazadua. Big kick answer, though, from Thompson.
It's hard to look, you know, to figure out exactly where you are.
You have seen some up kick knockouts. And really looking for the arm bar. He gets the back of Bazadua.
You really have to be careful with those undercuts that we've been talking about tonight.
Right now, Thompson got both hooks in. Really, it's just a hands game now as far as looking to sink that rear naked choke.
And Bazadua doing a good job trying to hold on to those hands and not allow him to get close to his neck.
And Thompson tried to flip it in full guard, and only got in half guard. Bazadua doing a good job keeping that leg trapped. Big shot lane coming through. That's the end of the round. Bazadua quickly back up to his feet. Thompson got a few in there.
Oh yeah, he definitely got a few shots in there. Was on top, you know, most of the fight, or most of the round, I should say. And you know, those things count. He was able to score a nice takedown. So those things definitely begin to add up. Smiling in the cage too, so.
Time, perfectly timed to get it. He knew that he got taken down. He could hear it in his voice.
He could hear him. Again, that's where experience comes into play. You know, when you made a little bit of a mistake, but he's experienced, you know, being on his back.
Well, no, and Thompson's and hops quickly into full mount. And Rafael really doing a great job now of taking him out, trapping that leg and turning it.
And also trying to, you know, stretch Thompson out a little bit because he won't have as much leverage pushing down on his body if his leg is pushed back a little bit.
You're definitely in this position. Half guard is a lot better than being in full mount. Thompson doing a good job right there with his shoulder blades and doing some nice. Rafael doing a good job. You see that side. Thompson actually gets some of those shots through.
Isolate that elbow a little bit of Thompson.
Really looking to drink on that elbow and get something happen, make something happen here. Rafael looking to get back up, but Thompson not letting it in. A big shot.
Real nice shots by Thompson.
North south right now, and Thompson going to work on the body, really isolate that arm. He's got the arm trapped right now. Rafael knows it. He's got to stay tight, got the arm in the Kimura, and he's tapping out.
not too much you can do when you get in a position where the Kimura is on you like that.
Definitely from the top position like that, cranking that arm, it doesn't take much for the person to tap, and it's an extreme amount of pressure on the shoulder and the forearm and just everything. And Rafael, the smart fighter that he is, taps out.
Of course. You don't want to go in and, separate a shoulder, over something where, you're going to lose the fight anyway. Go back, live the fight another day.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Kevin Anderson, has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 54 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by Kimura and Silva.
Title at Cage Progression 9, Return of the Champions.
I know he said he wanted to make his